Hello everyone, I'm Neha and I'm here to talk about the new very progressive education policy launched by the government yesterday. The Union Cabinet has approved the policy which aims at overhauling the entire education system in India. This was a much needed, much called for step taken by the government. I personally am very happy to see some of the very transformational reforms proposed under this policy. I'm here to take you through the policy highlights, and it is important for each one of you who's a student, be it a school student or a college student. So let's get started. So now the HRD ministry is called the Education Ministry, that you must be aware of. The complete formulation of the policy was done through a consultative process. A lot of stakeholders were involved. Feedback was taken. A committee was formed under the chairmanship of Dr. K. Kasturi Rangan. And so this policy was formulated. Now, starting with the reforms at the school level, one of the major structural change that has happened is 10 plus 2 structure is now changed to 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4. Now, what does that mean? So this 5 year are the foundation years that start from the nursery to class 2. Third is the preparatory stage, which is class 3 to class 5. The next classification is the middle age education, which is class 6 to 8, and the fourth is the secondary education, which is going to be for 4 years from class 9th to 12th. Now, there are a lot of reforms, a lot of change in the curriculum. The structure of the entire system has been changed based on this classification. The primary, the foundation years of 5 years for that, The government is coming up with universalization of early childhood care education. What this exactly means is they are going to come up with a curriculum for nursery to class 2, which will be made by NCERT. They are going to link this with Sustainable Development Goals, SDG. And the methodology of the learning would be more activity-based, fun-based learning, experiential learning. So the curriculum would be designed in that manner. The next is the National Mission on Foundation Literacy and Numeracy that they have introduced. The basic intent of this is that from class 1 to 3, the intent is that the literacy level all across the country should be raised, and every child up to class 3 should have the basic knowledge of mathematics and basic literacy level. The main path breaking step that has been taken is now that the earlier the system was that till class 10th you were studying a curriculum which included all subjects. After 10th, based on your result, you would choose a particular stream, be it science, art or commerce, and then there will be specific subjects in that stream. Say if you take PCM, you study physics, chemistry, mathematics. Say you take PCB, you'll study physics, chemistry, biology. Now this system is going to change entirely, which is called now multidisciplinary. What exactly this means is that you can choose subjects as per your interest. And also, this has to go together. So now there is no separation between vocational, academic, curriculum, extracurricular activities. They all will be considered same. So what does that mean? Till now, singing, art, craft, dance, sport, all of these were considered as extracurricular activities, which was other than your academics. Now, this would all be treated as equal. So, in under multidisciplinary, if you want to take a subject of your interest, which is your major discipline, say mathematics, and along with that you want to study music, you can do that. So now you have lot of choices. You can study. Of course, that will depend. There'll be further more clarity given by the government that which all disciplines would be available in the school. But overall, the concept is if you want to do sports, say badminton, tennis, and then you have to select few of the other academic subjects out of your as per your interest, you can combine them and make a course structure that suits you. So this is a revolutionary change, because earlier it was like बच्चों को रोका जाता था कि डोंट गेट इन्वॉल्व टू मच इन स्पोर्ट्स बिकॉज यू आर गोइंग टू लूज मार्क्स इन स्टडीज एंड देन इट इज गोइंग टू इम्पैक्ट योर करियर. नाउ एक्चुअली यू कैन मेक अ करियर एज पर योर पैशन, एज पर योर इंटरेस्ट. ओके, सो द करिकुलम वुड बी designed in a manner that there are more, life skills, problem solving skills could be inculcated in a student, critical thinking, project based learning. So all these concepts would be introduced in the curriculum, so the entire curriculum would be revised and the computer language will be introduced from class 6 onwards. Many of the school do it even today, but now this would be mandatory for all the schools. Next is a big change in the pattern of board exams. Now the board exams, the pattern of question formation of questions will be changed. Earlier it used to be, more of you have to mug up the answers, the definitions. There were teachers, I remember, during our time who wanted the same language as it was written in the book. Otherwise, we used to lose marks. So now this entire approach is going to change. There'll be more application-based questions so that the student attains conceptual clarity, understands the subject and its application. Also, the second the reform that has been proposed is there would be a semester kind of a system. There will be 2 6-month semesters. There will be two exams, and the final score would be sum of these two exams. Multilingual, the policy says that there will be preference for local regional languages. So till class 5th, or if required till class 8th, student may continue his studies in the regional languages. They've shortlisted a few languages, so student may continue his studies. So there will be no compulsion of studying in English. You can choose your regional language or continue your studies in that up till class 8th, and if required, if there might be in provision, there might be provision in some schools for higher studies also. From class 6th onwards, basically from class 6th to 8th, there'll be vocational learning. The purpose of this, there'll be 10 days of bagless school where the idea is the student should learn certain other skills other than the academics, like they may like be carpenter, electrician, plumber. So they would be associated with one of these areas. They would go to these people, stay with them for 10 days and learn all those skills. So our current education system is more, driven ma driven on the marks. The focus is only to get, maximum marks. So that is how it goes. But now the idea is that a child should have an overall development. overall development of his personality. So other than the academics, he should be learning one extra skill that would he should be nurturing over the years, and which adds to his overall report card. The next thing that they've spoken about in the policy is 360 degree holistic report card. What does this actually mean? That traditionally what happens is that the kind of report card that you get is you have your subject listed, you have your marks listed, and maybe the division, and then you have final remarks from the teacher. Now this approach is going to change. So there is going to be a 360 degree evaluation, which will have three components. One is self-assessment. How do you assess yourself? Second is peer level assessment. How does your friends, your peer assess you? So this is a very different concept that has been introduced. And third is the assessment by the teacher. So this is going to change the entire evaluation process in the school. So the idea is to track the learning outcomes, you know. So it certainly means that the purpose is not just to focus on academics, but lot of other skills, how you are with your friends, you know, lot of other things would matter now. And child would want to focus on lot of things that are of his interest, and lot of other life skills that are required in life. Use of technology is the another focus area. As you know, that the condition that we are in today because of this pandemic was totally unforeseen. We could have never thought of something like this could ever come up. So the schools, the education system, along with the other people, were not prepared to handle such a situation. But in future, such a situation doesn't happen. So it becomes important that schools are equipped to have, you know, they have technology in place for their teaching, for their administration, for the assessment. Today, we really don't know. I mean, most of the major exams, IIT, NDA, MC, etc., are all held up because there is no mechanism to conduct these exams online and to ensure that, you know, it is done in the appropriate manner. So going forward, we'll have technology in place to ensure all this. Then the policy also mentions about the promotion of book reading and digital libraries. The idea is to promote reading among the students because it has a lot of advantages, a lot of value to the child. Then the board would be fixing, they'll be having an upper cap on the fee, which means the maximum limit for the fees would be decided. The institutes would not be able to charge beyond that maximum limit. There'll be a national assessment center named PARAK. The full form of PARAK is Performance Assessment Review and Analysis of Knowledge for Holistic Development. The idea is there are a lot of school boards across the country. So the idea is to prepare uniform guidelines, norms for all these boards to have a kind of a standardization across for all these school boards. Something like this has never happened before. Every board follows their own standards, but now there'll be uniformity across the boards. There'll be a national professional standard for teachers, which means that they'll be defining the expectations from the teachers and certain benchmarks that the teachers would look up to. This is very important because the kind of system that we are talking about is easier said than done. You know, this is a big transformational change that is, you know, going to happen over a period of time. And this requires a lot of change in the mindset of teachers. You know, when we say that the question papers would be designed in such a way that they test your fundamental conceptual knowledge, so you know, there has to be a lot of training, lot of capacity building that has to go in the background so that the teachers are able to, you know, take this this policy forward. They should be able to bring this on paper. Now we'll come to higher education. So this is for students who are in college or would be going to college. So one of the major change that was there in school education also is multidisciplinary education, which means that you can choose subjects of your choice. You can combine physics with photography, you can combine biology with singing. I mean, whatever you like to do, there'll be a lot of choices for you to make and make your career as per your passion, as per your interest. The next big change is multiple entry and exit. What does this mean? This means that you would have a choice to take a break in while doing your graduation or post-graduation. Say for some reason, due to financial crisis or family situation or some other personal problem, you are not able to continue with your studies. So in that case, you'll have an option to go for a sabbatical, to take a break for a fixed period of time, which will be defined by government, and then come back again and continue with your studies. This is really, really, you know, it is going to be helpful because it happens at times that for certain reasons, people need to take a break. So now you have this option available. Also say if you totally, you know, you do your first year and you discontinue. Suppose in current situation, you join engineering, you study for 2 years and for some reason, you're not able to continue. So you don't get any recognition for the 2 years that you've spent in the college. Now that is not going to happen. So say for example that you complete your first year, you get a certificate for that. You complete second year of your graduation, you get an advanced diploma certificate. You complete your third year, you get a bachelor's degree, and fourth year, that is the final year, you get bachelor's degree with research options. So which means that even if you discontinue in between, you get acknowledgement for the time that you have spent in college. Other than that, you get credit points. So what are these credit points? That you have spent say 2 years in your college, you have certain credit points with you, which is kind of, you know, you understand the DigiLocker that the government has launched. So there would be a system where these credit points would be stored, which is an authentic source of information. Then when you decide to come back and continue your studies, you can say that I've completed my 2 years of education. I have these many credit points and I'll join back in my third year. So this is a big transformational change. Something that happens in abroad is also, you know, maybe sometime we'll reach to that level also, that you get credit points and you're able to reduce the duration of your entire course. Say there are certain points allocated for each semester, and then It is not essential that you take complete 1 year to you take 1 year to complete the curriculum. So you can actually complete a 4 years curriculum in 3 years. So we have still not reached that stage, but nevertheless, this is going to be very revolutionary, which has never happened till now. Then NTA, National Testing Agency, would offer a common entrance exam. So this certainly doesn't mean, I mean, there is no clarity that it is going to replace all your IIT and other exams. No, it is, it would, NTA would propose such a test, which would be conducted. Certain institute may consider this score along with your 12th score to give you admission in colleges. So now every undergraduate program would be of 3 or 4 years. PG program, there are certain PG programs like MCA, which are of 3 years, but now every PG program would be of 1 or 2 years. Integrated 5 year program for bachelor's and master's degree. Then there'll be a national mission on mentoring. So there'll be mentors trained for you, whom a student can consult and who can help students in grooming their career and achieving their career goals. There'll be common norms for all public and private institutes. Currently, there are different norms for deemed universities, central universities, state universities. So on quality parameters, now there is going to be a standardization and there are going to be uniform norms, common norms for all public and private institutions. And there is going to be a single regulator for higher education, like UGC, AICTE, they'll all be combined now, and there is going to be just one single regulator for all institutes. Now they've spoken about National Research Foundation. You must have heard about National Science Foundation, which is in US. The purpose is to finance the research projects. In India, they've named it as National Research Foundation, and other than science subjects, they've included social sciences in this. So this is basically to promote innovation. The idea is to promote innovation. Then they've talked about National Education Technology Forum. The concept is they want to create a platform where private sector, government sector, educationalists and technologists are on a common platform and can be benefited mutually. Then there will be certain changes made in the education system. It would be made, it would be brought to a level which encourages foreign students to come and study in India, because that is going to promote a lot of things. When foreign students come to a country, it just doesn't help in the development of the education system, but there are a lot of things related which are benefited. E-content, which is usually available, the learning content on the net, which is usually available in universities is mostly in English or in Hindi, but now it will be available in 8 regional languages. They've shortlisted certain languages for that, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Gujarati, Marathi, Uriya, Bengali. So there are certain languages that they have shortlisted. So e-learning content would be available in all those 8 languages. Then they've spoken about promoting traditional art and craft in the country and to increase cultural awareness of Indian knowledge system. So on a broader level, the outcomes of this policy, the outcomes are going to be huge. I mean, I feel happy about the students who are in this phase, that who will be actually realizing the benefits of this change in the pattern of the entire education system. So now the board exams is going to test the core concept and application of knowledge. This is going to be a big change. Every child will come out of school apt at least in one skill. So you have people who are trained not just in academic subjects, but in other skills also. There'll be common standards of learning in public and private schools. There'll be technology-based learning. Online education will be promoted. There'll be a guidelines and a mechanism for, for recruitment of teachers and their learning and their career path. And overall, there's going to be an inclusive system for education. When we talk about inclusion, we talk about gender inclusion. We talk about differently abled students. We talk about gifted students. They have talked about gifted students also. What provisions? Gifted students are those who are very, very brilliant students. So they can be promoted to, more than one level, two level as per their performance. So they have considered various aspects to make an inclusive policy. Then people who are not economically at par, there are provisions for them. So basically, it is a holistic a policy covering various aspects, and I'm hoping that this is going to make big change in the education system in India, which we are really, really looking forward to. Thank you.